My flight was supposed to go from Charlotte to Newark and then across the Pacific here. And then we get to Japan. Hey, Japan. And then Vietnam. Hey, look at that. There's Ho Chi Minh City, Saigon. Look at this graphic I got to make. It's so cool. It took so long. It took so much hours. Yeah, it's never that simple. Come on, you didn't actually think I was gonna make that flight, right? We still start in Charlotte and you get to go to the greatest airport on Earth, Newark. You're thinking Japan? Well, think otherwise, because we got to go to San Fran instead. A trip across the Pacific Ocean, and then now we're in Korea. Let me tell you, that Korean airport might have been the nicest airport I've ever been to. And this is where we go to Vietnam. Here are the two maps compared side by side. Originally, it was supposed to take me 28 hours. Instead, I got there in a record 43 hours.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're...
So it turns out going across the world to another country is no easy task. No, it's not. It's really hard. So you got to do some research about flights, more research about the requirements to get into the country. You finally got to buy the ticket. And then that's where you think your problems are done, right? Nope, because not really. Because the odds of your itinerary being correct are slim to zero in this case, especially if you're boarding multiple flights, which is what I'm doing. So with that in mind, I did my research. I almost forgot about the visa part, which is kind of useful. Shout out to my parents for knowing a guy. Bought the flights and left several hours in layover so that I could still make my flight even if it was delayed. So you kind of leave that little gap. Even if your flights get delayed, you'll be fine. So this is a simple Google search that you can do. And then here's like the top three choices. Oh, you got a 3 out of 10. Solid. Solid. 1.3 out of 5 in stars from 64 reviews. Whole lot of one stars, but right here is probably the big one. It ranked 6 out of 7 North American airlines in terms of 8 factors, including baggage, boarding, cost and fees, in-flight services. But yeah, United's not the best airline. So I booked that not really knowing if it was probably the best choice, but I was like, you know, I left enough time. April 12th at like 3 a.m. We got to get to the airport at 4 because I don't want to be messing with this stuff. Have my roommate drive me to the airport, start the day. Charlotte to Newark is a very short flight, so I would be really surprised if there were any problems on this flight. Like, this is, you get 50 minutes of flight and then the rest is just taxiing. Like, it's simple flight. No delays, no problems there. Newark isn't the best airport in the world. Kind of hard to navigate, not the best looker. People look miserable, but it's 9 a.m., so I'll give them the benefit of the doubt there. I was hoping she'd just get the job done. When I got to Newark, I had about an hour and 30 minutes of layover in Newark. And then off to Japan. Hey, Japan, look at that. And then about 30 minutes into me getting settled by the terminal, I get the text notification that my flight's been delayed. I'm like, ee. So I can keep it going. As long as there's no more delays, it's fine. But then the delays kept coming. And they won't stop coming and they won't stop coming. If everything works out perfectly, I could make my flight. I was like, oh, okay, cool. And then one of the delays diverted us to San Fran. So that's what really took out most of it. It was like probably like a 30 minute delay until they wanted to divert us to San Fran. And I was like, that killed about 2 hours of my layover. If nothing else got delayed, I'd still be able to make the flight, but probably barely. I hop on the plane, meet some really cool people that sat next to me. And they were going to Japan for their honeymoon, which is adorable. Because it's supposed to be an international flight, we got served meals from Newark to San Fran. So I'm like, okay. Except the dessert they gave us was milk bar, and boy, milk bar is fire. Like, milk bar is kind of delicious. So would 10 out of 10, would not slander milk bar. And then I land in San Fran. And the first text I got off the plane is, your flight from San Fran to Japan has been delayed. Yeah, it's a frick. Terrible. Not great. But I was like, hey, should I go to Japan for funsies when I know I'm not going to be making my flight? So I went to the United agent and I'm like, hey, bro, my flight is supposed to leave in like 10 minutes. I'm like, please stop dragging me around in a circle. The one problem though was that she did not have the power to change my flights. She was just a customer service rep. So... she got me hooked up though. Like, she got me a meal voucher. I was like, oh, that's nice. Like, oh, I got a little bit of free food. I'm like, hey, okay, I can eat. Like, that's nice. Essentially, what ended up me having to do is that I had to call their hotline So call United. I'm like, all right, sick. Let's go. Let's jump on the call. While this was happening, my time frame to getting on the plane was slowly ticking away. So it was about an hour to get to decide. And then now, because this didn't really resolve anything, I had about 30 minutes. So I was kind of freaking out a little bit. I was like, oh, do I jump on the flight? Do I jump on the flight to Japan? So I get on the call with the agent. Agent asks where I am, and I'm like, I'm in San Fran. Then he asks why I'm in San Fran. I'm like, You guys are the reason why I'm in San Fran. I'm not in San Fran for the fun of it. I didn't just book a personal flight from Charlotte to San Fran. Then I had to explain to them that they'd never did the plane from the previous flight I took. So originally my flight's supposed to be Newark to Japan, but now it's Newark to San Fran to Japan, which kind of screwed me over there a little bit. The agent said that there's another flight I can book in Japan, but you can barely make it. So no more delays. No more delays, okay? I'm like, ah, sick.
You sure about
I'm like,
that?
Oh, easy. All right, sure back on course, that, baby. That's... And then about 10 minutes later, after I ended that phone call, the flight from San Fran to Japan got delayed again, so. Rather useless call that I had there. So yeah, I got delayed by like 10, and then another delay happened, and it got delayed by like 30, and I was like, not making this flight. Not making this flight again. So that's two planes I can't make. So just to recap, I am surprisingly in San Fran. I wasn't expecting to be in San Fran. I rebooked my first flight because I was gonna miss it because of the delays. Got to San Fran, rebooked my flight again because of delays, and then now I'm kind of stuck in San Fran with two flights that I can't make. So not really useful at all. So you see the pattern here? See the pattern? Just keeps going. So I jumped on the phone again, my trusty phone. The agent asked me where I currently am. I'm like, hey, I'm in San Fran. Hey, why are you in San Fran? I'm like, bro, update your system, please. You diverted the plane. Like, should all be there. Should be there. Should be in your system. They're like, ah, okay. I'm like, oh, this does not sound like it's in their system. Anyways, during the call, there's another flight. Hey, guys, another flight that I can make in Japan. I'm like, oh, shoot. So I'm supposed to jump on this flight? He's like, yeah, jump on the flight. I'm like, oh, cool. I only have about 30 minutes until I board. So I'm like, okay, San Fran to Japan. Everything solves itself. And then I get off the phone. I get off the phone with this guy. And then the confirmation comes almost instantly about my new little flight. Yeah, and I was confused. I was like, this doesn't seem right. This isn't the same airport that I booked in Japan. This is a different airport. I'm like, there's only like a two hour layover until I get to this flight. I'm like, okay. It takes about 2 hours. I'm screwed. I can't make this flight for a third time. So anyways, I jump on the phone again, and there's maybe about like 15, 20 minutes till my gate boards. I'm like, hey, this last agent rebooked my flight, but it's at a different airport, yada, yada, yada. Hey, where are you currently at? I'm like, oh, fuck, dude, I'm in San Fran. You guys diverted me from Newark. I'm like, please, like, I don't want to be in San Fran. Like, I was never supposed to be in San Fran. And then I get two options. I can take the flight from San Fran to Japan, which is boarding, like, right now, by the way. Stay 8-ish hours in the hotel there. And then hit a flight from Japan to Vietnam. So I arrived in Vietnam in the evening, like Ho Chi Minh City, Saigon, in the evening. Not ideal, losing a couple days there. Don't like travel as part of my vacation. Or, better yet, I can cancel my flight to Japan and find another airline that has flights there. I'm like, dude, let's do something crazy. Cancel my flight from Newark to Japan to Vietnam. Cancel that, and then I'll just book another airline. Sick. Don't have to jump on this plane. And then I asked the agent, yo, will my if I cancel this flight, will my bags be fine? Don't airlines normally handle the checked bags? And then the agent was like, don't worry. You're fine. You don't have to do anything about it. I'm like, sick. Love that. Finally free. We're gone. We're cool. Everything's awesome. I booked Asiana Airlines because they got me to Vietnam in the morning. I just had to fly through like Seoul, Korea, Incheon Airport. I was like, that's fine with me. I'm like, I always wanted to visit Korea too. I sit there looking at the window. I'm like, oh, that's my flight. I could have been on that flight and it leaves. And then I get some food from the San Fran Airport. Here's the video. Kind of bomb. Free. Love free. Free is a great one because I was like, dang, I'm kind of getting hungry and I don't get my international flight food until like a couple hours later. So I have to wait like 6 hours chilling. I'm like, that's fine. San Fran Airport, kind of cool airport, definitely better than Newark. And then while I'm eating my food, I look at the confirmation I got from when the United agent canceled my flight. Turns out my entire confirmation got canceled.
Bruh.
Like, including the departure and arrival, everything got canceled. I was like, I need to get home from Vietnam. I'm not staying in Vietnam. Like, I would love to, but that's just not how it works. That's okay. Okay. In my head, I'm like, okay, that's fine. Let's book a flight back now. Let's figure out a flight back because it gets more expensive. I went through Google Flights. I was like, all right, get me home same day, same time as I wanted. And it cost, the one-way trip cost the entire round trip. It cost more than my round trip to get out of Vietnam. I was like, huh? Bro, I'm not made out of cash anymore. I quit my job for this. Like, nothing's coming in. Yes! Love it! So I call United for a fourth time. Hey, where are you at? I'm in San Fran. Like, you guys diverted me. Please put it in your system. Please put a note. Something. I don't want to be explaining this conversation multiple times. Ideally, this is the last time I explain this conversation, but that's what I thought after the first one, and now I'm on call four, so who knows? Told him everything, and this is probably the least useful agent because the dude was like, sorry, can't help. You're screwed. Just book another flight through the app. I'm like, huh? He's like, yeah, just book another flight through the app. I'm like, okay. And then he canceled on me. He hung up. I was like, so I was like, bro, I'm putting up a fight. I will put up a fight to get my shit back because I only wanted like two flights canceled and I got five flights canceled. I was like, what happened? Let's give it another like 10 minutes. Let's finish my food. Let's call United again. Fifth time. Okay, may I ask where you're calling from? San Fran. So it turns out this actually became the best agent that I worked with, and it was by far the best. Dude was nice, kept me updated, reached out to his manager to see what he could do, tried to get me back on the flights. It took about an hour and 30 minutes for this man to solve this situation with his boss. I was like, bro, that's dedication for one customer. I'm like, thank you so much. He was like, cool. Like, even he understood the situation. I was like, yo, I felt like I could fist bump him through the phone. And then we were wrapping up the conversation. He was like, oh, last bit of news that he gave me. I see you never got your bag out while you were in San Fran. Your bag's now in Japan, or is it on the way to Japan? You'll have to create a claim with your new airline so you can get your luggage. I'm like, huh? But what?
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
I was told by a prior agent I was fine. Turns out I wasn't. And then he transferred me to a claims agent, which actually wasn't that bad. Pretty mild conversation. I was like, hey, where are you calling us from? San Fran. Got through all that. And then I got on my Asiana flight to Korea and then to Ho Chi Minh City several hours after that. Kind of chill, kind of hung out in the airports. The Seoul/Incheon airport, fire. Fire airport, best airport that I've like seen, that I've been to. I actually got to lay down. Like, I haven't been, so far it's been like 18 hours in this journey. And I'm like, yo. Or no, it's been more than 18 hours. It's been about 30 something hours. And I'm like, yo, let me just lay down. Let me just lay down one second. I lay down and I was like, oh, dude, I could go to sleep here. But I'm like, oh, I want to explore the rest of the airport. So I got to see like all the art installations. They had like Versace, like art, like little art panel. I was like, oh, that's really cool. They had some like cool looking stores. You had the Korean like beauty store. I'm like, ooh, this is how you look like a K-pop star. And then I look at the prices. I'm like, I can't afford a K-pop star look. Can't do that. So yeah, cool airport, looked great. It was like 5 a.m. and everything was starting to open up, but the only things that were opening up were American chains. So I was like, I don't really want to be in a Korean airport buying Dunkin' Donuts. And then shout out to Asiana Airlines. Their food was solid. Their dessert was so good. I had a cheesecake for my trip from San Fran to Korea, and that cheesecake was so good. And if you know me, I love cheesecake. So that was fire. Thank you. And then also, don't be mad. Yeah, might say Asiana right there. Yeah. So don't be mad if I took a blanket. It's just that your blankets are really nice. And like, maybe it was because I was cold. Maybe it's, honestly, I got this from Momo, not me. Yeah, just from Momo. It's so comfortable. So, That's how I came out of this trip with an Asiana Airlines blanket, am I right? Finesse them! Had to call United about 13 times, but hey! I'll be releasing more videos of my Vietnam trip soon, so be on the lookout for that. Subscribe if you haven't already, and if you've gotten this far into the video, you seem like you'd like the rest of my Vietnam content. So, be on the lookout, man. Pretty sure my next video will be the hotel video, and then I'll probably do a video on just like the trip as a whole, being Asian American or Vietnamese American specifically, and then going to Vietnam, and then my conclusions that came out of there, because there's a lot. You think you guys have it rough? I got called Korean like 26 times. I was like, bro, I don't look much different. I'm looking at you, you're looking at me, I'm looking in a mirror. I'm like, I look closer to you than the Korean dudes that are over there. I'm like, those guys look like models. They look so good. I just have okay skin because my face isn't staring at the sun that is 100 degrees there. That's it.
If somebody asks why I'm in San Fran one more freaking time, I swear to God.